Okay, good afternoon, children. Welcome to SBR online classes. Yesterday we have started Christianity and Islam revision. Already we have learned in detail about the rise of Christianity, the teachings of Jesus Christ, and today we are going to study how Christianity spread all over the world. So today in the world, major religions in the world means first comes Christianity, then next comes Islam, then the remaining religions become the next ladder of religions. Okay. So today we are going to study how the Christianity, the spread of Christianity all over the world. Already we have studied in our previous classes, that is that how Christianity has spread. So Jesus Christ had 12 disciples, understood, 12 shishyendru, also we can call followers. So these people, when Jesus Christ died, so they spread Christianity in their places in and around the world. So these people, they're also responsible for spreading the Christianity all over the world. Who were that? The followers of Jesus Christ. Then next up, Christian missionaries. So here Christian missionaries means group of people who are engaged in spreading the religions far and wide. So even Christian missionaries, which were the lands from newly lands, that is Africa, North America, South America, Asia, all these new lands were found out, and these people, Christian missionaries, in groups they had gone and spread their Christianity all over the world, even in India. So before, in India Christians were not there, Muslims were not there in India. When did the Muslims come to India after this conquer of Muhammad Ghazni and Muhammad Ghori, Arabs coming to India? From then onwards, Muslim people started staying in India, and conversion also took place. In this way, more number of Muslims started living in India. Islam spread in India. Then Christianity, when the Christian missionaries came to India, then the traders, they established colonies in India. From there, then onwards, Christianity increased in India. Understood. So they started preaching about the teachings of Jesus Christ, and they started giving facilities to the people. They said that suppose if you convert yourself to Christianity, so we will give all the facilities for your children, free educational facilities, free housing facility, job offer, all these things they offered. So what happened? The poor people in olden days, before 1947, before 1947. So the people, uneducated people, poor people, what they will do? When they are getting all the facilities, definitely they will convert into other religions. Why? Because the religion is providing so many facilities for their life. So the poor people, most of the poor people in India, they started converting into Christianity, and in this way Christian population in India became more. Understood? Then next, contributions of Christianity. So already we have studied in our history lessons, what were the contributions of Rajkots, contributions of Burmese, contributions of Vijayanagara, all this. Contributions means what they have given to the people. or to the society or to the country. So events, there is a lot of contributions of Christianity towards the society. What is the first one? What Christianity has taught to the people? Christianity has taught to the people peace and brotherhood. All live together, all living peace, shanti. Understood? This it has taught. So I'll write the points in the board. Please note down in your rough notebook or classwork. Suppose if you are not interested, please note down in your mind. Okay. Okay, children. What is Christianity, children? It is one of the religions of the world. Write down, children. First contribution, Christianity taught principles of peace and brotherhood to the earth. Second contribution. That is Christianity taught principles of peace and brotherhood to the world means. So Christianity taught the people to live in peace and love each other, though you belong to any religion. Then growth of education. So Christianity also worked hard to spread education all over the world. Growth of education. Malikarjun, those are sleeping right there. After the okay, next growth of education. So how can you say that Christianity helped in the growth of education? These Christian missionaries not only spread their religion, even they started establishing schools, English medium schools in wherever they had established colonies, not trading colonies. So there they went and spread or started educational institutions. So that is the schools and colleges. Okay, schools especially. So in this way, Christianity also contributed in the spread of education, growth of educational institutions. Then, next, third one. Missionaries extended health services. See, even they were thinking about the health of the people. Health is wealth, we say. Yes or no? If health is there, we can contribute anything, we can do anything, and development of the country also takes place very fast. Understood? Yes or no? So even these Christian missionaries also helped us in providing health services. Understood? So they also gave the knowledge to the people that how to live healthy. And suppose if the people were not willing at all, they were supplying some, medicines, like that, helping the people. Then, qualitative education in the society. Next. Qualitative education. Thank you. of Vedic period, our gurus, they institute quality education. Quality education means good education. What good education provides us? It makes us to learn all the good habits, to be disciplined, to be strict, understood, punctuality, everything, hardworking, all these will be taught in, what is that, in qualitative education. Even the Christian missionaries, they gave to the society qualitative education. Okay, next. Now next, that is after religious reformation movement. What is religious reformation movement? Shall I write this here? Okay. So after religious reformation movement, we already have studied in the lesson modern Europe, Christianity was divided into two, that is Catholics and Protestants. Understood? So there are two sects in the Christianity. One is Catholics. Second one is Protestants. So who are more in number in the world today? Okay. Then next, children, one more thing. In the Bible, which is the holy book of scriptures, originally it was in which language? Latin language, or they call it as Hebrew language. So that, Bible. Can I write that, children? In Bible also there is Old Testament, New Testament. Two parts are there in the Bible. We are having Old Testament and New Testament. What is that Old Testament deals with? And what is that New Testament and Old Testament deals with? What is that? Bible. Okay, so which is the holy book of Hindus? In Bhagavad Gita, whose teachings are there?
Krishna.
Lord Krishna. Like that, here in the Bible, you know, we are having Bible. In Bible, we have Old Testament, New Testament. What is this Old Testament? What is this New Testament? We need. See, Old Testament in the Bible, there are two, parts, Old Testament and New Testament. Old Testament deals with religious beliefs of Jews. Understood. New Testament deals with the teachings of Jesus Christ. So in the Bible we find both teachings of Jews, teachings of Jesus Christ. Understood. Okay. So New Testament deals with healing of human rights. Okay, Old Testament deals with the teachings of teaching the beliefs of Jews. So even the Jesus Christ first, when he found out, before finding out Christianity, he was a Jew, he belonged to Judaism. The next New Testament, it deals with teachings of Jesus Christ. So in our Bible, we find both Old Testament, New Testament. Old Testament deals with the teachings and beliefs of Jewish people. New Testament deals with teachings of Jesus. So what we find in the Bible? First, the Bible was in which language? Latin language. Then after religious reformation movement of Martin Luther, it was written in all the languages in Europe. So when the Bible was written in the languages, various languages, people were easily could read and understand the teachings of Jesus Christ. The next is it. That is, next we are going to study about Islam. Islam also is one of the major religions of the world. So now we will study about Islam. What it is Islam? It is one of the major religion of the world. First part, second, the founder of Who were the parents of Muhammad Paigambar?
Abdullah and Abdullah.
Please, children, load up. Okay. Where do you find Mecca and Medina? So Mecca and Medina are the holy places of Muslims. Next point is align there.
Yes.
So Mehta and Malina are the only faces of okay. So when he was very small, Muhammad Paighambar, he lost his parents and he was brought up by his uncle. So in this way, you know, he grew big. Then when naturally when we become big, grew big, naturally we have to do job. Yes sir. So when Muhammad Paighambar became big, he went from place to place in search of job, business. So there he will come across a business lady called Khadija. So he will be working under her. Then afterwards what happened? He gets married to Khadija only. So in age, he will be more senior and elder than him. But then to get married. And will have children. Then afterwards what happened? Wife and children will become the first followers of his teachings. That is Muhammad Paighambar's teachings. And afterwards what happened? Daily Muhammad Paighambar used to go on the mountain and used to meditate there. So when he was meditating daily, after long time meditation, he got some supernatural powers. And miracles also have taken place. There did many miracles also. So people started believing in his teaching. So in this way, what happened? Muhammad Paighambar became famous among the mass. Why he became famous among the mass? Because he was teaching good to the people, doing good for the people. So all became his followers. So when all the people became his followers in Mecca, some of the rulers, they felt jealous of him. Understood? They felt jealous of him. And what happened? He chased Muhammad Paighambar from Mecca to Madina. So what happened? Without tolerating the humiliation of the people, he left Mecca and went to Madina. So now the people of Madina welcome Muhammad Paighambar in a respectful manner, right? Because the people of Madina understood the value of the teachings of Muhammad Paighambar. So there in Madina he became famous. Became famous. Most of the people in Madina, they began to follow him. Then afterwards, the people of Mecca understood the value of Muhammad Paighambar and his teaching. Then they said, sorry, come back to Mecca. Understood? So in this year, what happened? Muhammad Paighambar, he became famous among the mass. And most of the people became his followers. He was a father of Islam. From then onwards, Islam started. Then, what am I? What are the teachings of Islam? What does Islam teach? Islam teaches that God is one. God is one. Understood? Even picture it also says God is one. But Hinduism also says that God is one. But what in Hinduism they do, you know, they worship God in different forms. Right. So for some, God means Krishna only. So there you mention God having the murti or idol of Krishna, like that. But in what say Christianity or Islam, they won't worship any idol. Idol worship is forbidden. So they say that God is one. They the teachings of Islam are given below. Sorry. A simple prayer is enough to win the heart of the God. Okay. Does God want anything from you all? Flowers or fruits or anything? Wait. He doesn't want anything. Just he says that God says, just you ask, just you pray to me, and whatever you want, you ask me. I'm ready to give you, help you. Understood? He does not want anything from the people. Why? Because he has everything. He is the creator of the world. What he wants from us? Anything he wants, sir? So no expectations from the people. God does not expect anything from the people, because he is creator of the world. Understood? It is the people. What they do? They offer everything. Offer what is that? Fruits, flowers, everything to God. Okay. So one of the teachings of Islam is they say that God is one, and a simple prayer is enough to win the heart of the God. The next one should be honest. I principle life and keep away all the bad habits. So never cultivate all the bad habits. Lead a good life. Understood? Help the nation, help the people as far as possible. How much is how much you can help? How much possibility is there to you or in you? Help the people as far as possible. Understood? Then next. One should have respect for women and compassion for the poor and weak. So every religion says the same thing. Give respect to women. Never ill treat her. Understood? So then again, what is that? Help the poor as far as possible. How much it is possible to help the poor people? So it says these are the teachings of. Then what are the rituals of Islam? Ready? What are the duties of a Muslim? You know that duties of Muslim. So they have to pray, right? Children. Duties of a Muslim. Duties of a Muslim. A Muslim should pray 5 times a day. Okay. All right, the board. Okay, so you have to pray 5 times a day facing to the direction of Mecca and Medina. Understood? Usually what we do, we pray God in front of the murti and all in Hinduism. But here in the Muslims, you know, in Islam, who is a Muslim, he has to pray 5 times a day compulsory facing the direction of Mecca. The next is fasting during the month of Ramzan. Then going at least once to Mecca and Medina, pilgrimage, holy places. going to holy places Mecca and Medina once in lifetime. We say Mecca and Medina. One day, like that. Okay, right out of it. So give alms to the poor, help the poor. So especially during the month of Ramzan, you know, the poor people will be given some new clothes, not old, new clothes, or some grain, money. Not only during the month of Ramzan, during other times also you can help the poor. So what happens when we help the poor, we also will get the basic necessities of life. They will not suffer. So helping the poor, it is helping God. Understood? What is body? Then expansion of Islam. How Islam spread? So after when Muhammad Paigambar died, his followers are called as Caliphs. So these people, Caliphs, they spread the message of Muhammad Paigambar all over the world. Not only in Arabia, so the remaining thing tomorrow is tradition.